Today we're going to talk about the first sections for MAT 1033. So I want to stress some important pieces here real quick for you. My math lab has videos for every single section. They are awesome videos. They cover each type of idea. We are not touching on every single idea. We are hitting the highlights of what we know we tend to make mistakes on, where we tend to have challenges, so that you have some of those helpful hints. So this video is extremely important because it does actually give you some of those pieces you need. So it is not something that I would skip for doing my math lab and vice versa. My math lab covers more ideas. Ours, though, hits everything that we're going to tend to make mistakes on. So we're going to start with the helpful hints on the top of this page. So the first one is probably one that I think is one of the most important ones for y'all. This will be for the whole course. Anytime you're solving an equation with fractions, I want you to get in the habit of clearing your fractions. But the key is it has to be every single term. Okay. So I like to underline each term before I start. Second check tip is that you can always check your answers. So there's no excuse on this first test to not get almost all of them right, because you're going to finish quickly. You have time to check your answers. Don't press submit until you've checked them. The last two lines are what we call our special cases. So I like to label these that. What's going to happen on both of these special cases is that my variables will cancel out when I'm solving. So I'll get 0x, and people get confused with that. 0 times anything is 0, so the x is gone. Okay. If you get a special case where the variable is gone, you need to ask yourself, does it make a false statement or a true statement? So an example of a false statement would be if you got 2 equals 5. That doesn't work. So my answer then is no solution, which is empty set. If I get a true statement, I get 2 equals 2. Or 20 equals 20, then my answer is all real numbers. And I get a lot of people that confuse these. You're going to have this on your quiz and your test. Stop and say, what makes a true statement? What makes a false statement? Nothing works for 2 equals 5, so nothing works for my answer. 2 equals 2, everything works. So we're going to go to the first example, which is a fraction problem. So I'm going to start off. So that I'm super clear, I have 4 terms that I'm going to be multiplying by my LCD. So my LCD in this case looks at the denominators, which is 2 and 4. So the only number that's going to work here to get rid of both of those is a 4. So when you are writing your problem down from my math lab, when you have fractions, what I suggest doing is leave space so that you can multiply each term, not in your head, but you can do it on your paper, and in this case I'm multiplying by 4 or 4 over 1. So I'm going to multiply by 4 over 1 if it's a fraction, and by 4 if it's not. I have to do every term. That is the key step. So for my first term, I'm going to get 20 over 2, which is 10x, minus 4 equals 4x. My last term, I'm going to get 4 over 4, which simplifies to 1. So much easier to solve this problem than the fraction problem. Can you solve a fraction leaving them? Yes. But if it's a fraction problem, do not give a decimal answer. So y'all need to really look at what is in the answer blank on my math lab, because it usually will tell you what format it wants the answer in. So I'm now going to collect like terms on the same side. So I'm going to subtract 4x to move it to the other side. This gives me 6x minus 4 equals 1. I'm going to add 4 to both sides. I get 6x equals 5. And my last step is the multiplication and division step to get the x by itself and isolate it. It always has to be x equals. Cannot be a negative x equals. It's got to be x equals. So my answer here is 5/6. Easy to check on a test and a quiz. Please plug it back in. You can do it with your calculator to make sure the left side equals the right side. So going to number 2. We have a problem with decimals. This is a problem that I suggest you have an option. Fractions, I always tell you to clear them. Decimals, since you have a calculator, it's up to you. But I would clear my parentheses first because I think it's confusing for some of you on what's a term and what's not. So I'm going to go ahead and distribute. Multiply 0.6 times 300, I'm going to get 180. And I'm just bringing everything else down right now. So now I'm going to multiply through and clear my decimals. And so I'm looking for the maximum amount of decimals. I have two decimals in three spots. So I have to multiply by 100 to move those. But again, you have to do it to every single term. So this one moves two places and it gives me 60Z. If there's no decimal place, it's assumed to be at the end. So I end up with 18,000. Gives me 5Z equals 7Z, 70Z. And again, be careful. Make sure you move it on every single term. So I end up with 20,500 at the end there. So I'm now going to collect like terms that are already on the same side, so I don't need to change any signs here. And now I am going to subtract 70Z from both sides. So those cancel. I get a negative 5Z. And my next step is going to be to add the 18,000 to both sides. So I'm going to add that piece. Again, you can use a calculator to solve any of these pieces or deal with the adding and subtracting. In this case, if I do this, I have a negative 2,500 left. And so my last step is to isolate the Z. So I'm going to divide by negative 5. A negative divided by a negative always cancels. My answer here is 500. I could have done this without clearing the decimals. It would have given me the same exact answer. If you're going to clear decimals, just like fractions, please be careful and do every single term. If you have a negative divided by a negative, you have to cancel those out. That's very important. All right. Any of these right now that we're starting to go through, good idea to maybe pause it, see if you can solve it yourself, and see if you get the answer. That's what we would have done in class. I would have actually had everybody work it out, and then we would have talked through it. So I'm going to go ahead and distribute, get rid of my parentheses. Be careful again of your sign. So I get a negative 12Z plus 10, which is super important. If it helps to draw the arrows so that you make sure you distribute it, but that's probably the most common mistake right there, is to not do that negative to both pieces. So now I'm going to collect any like terms that are already on the same side. Now I'm going to collect like terms that are already on the same side. So I end up with a negative 12Z plus 14. Some of you actually will notice that right now I have the same thing on the left and the right, which you could actually stop there. But a lot of you may not be paying attention to that. So you move your variables from one side to the other. And I notice I put a Z here for some reason. That should have been an X. Sorry, that wasn't meant. So I get 14 equals 14. That's a true statement. Some of you may go as far as getting 0 equals true. All of these are true statements, so my answer for this problem is all real numbers. In my math lab, they're going to have three choices for each one of these problems. It's going to say, you got an answer, you fill it in, like number one and two. Or your answer is all real numbers, or your answer is no solution. Special case means your variables disappear. If it's a true statement, your answer is all reals. If it's a false statement, your answer is no solution. So going to number four, I'm going to distribute. Again, being careful of my sign. Collect like terms. move my variables from the left to the right or my variables from the right to left, whichever way you want to do them. These cancel. And I like to cross them out because then you're not confused, because a lot of y'all want to say there's a Y left. If you put a Y, that means there's one left, one Y. This is zero Y. So now I get 17 equals 13. That's a false statement. So my answer here should be no solution. My answer is empty sets. So that's a quick refresher on 2.3, solving equations.